Hey, welcome to Grafana for Beginners. My name is Lisa Jung, and I'm a developer advocate at Grafana. Today, we're answering the question, what is observability? If you're new to this field, the technical definition of it may seem abstract. I'm a beginner myself, and I had the toughest time understanding what it was because of the jargon and concepts that were used to explain it. Now, I want you to have a different experience, so we're going to take away the complexity and jargon and explain observability in the simplest terms possible. You might have heard of this term being referred to as O11Y. The 11 here looks like two L's, so sometimes it's pronounced as Ollie. Now, developers like to be brief. Instead of spelling out or pronouncing observability, they took the first letter O and the last letter Y. There are 11 letters between these two letters, and hence the acronym O11Y was born. So let's talk about observability in terms of you. So think about your body right now. Your body consists of multiple systems that perform different functions. For example, your digestive system helps you digest food, whereas your circulatory system pumps blood throughout your body. Now, all of these systems come together to form one entity, you. So let's say one or multiple systems are not working properly. Suddenly your energy's off, you're having aches and pains, and you can't think clearly. So we gotta figure out what the problem is so we could fix it. So let's say you go to a doctor. First, they'll take your vitals, like your temperature, blood pressure, oxygen level, etc. Now, there's a normal range where your vitals should fall. If they observe something outside of this range, they'll know something is happening that they should look into. After taking vitals into account, the doctor will ask you a series of questions to get more context about what may be going on with you. She may run more tests to narrow down what's going on. And based on this info, let's say the doctor suspects that you have mild bleeding somewhere in your digestive tract. To figure out the source of the bleeding, the doctor could tag your red blood cells with tracers and visualize how the blood travels throughout your body. Now, at the source of the bleeding, a blood clot will likely to form around it. Therefore, the doctor could look for accumulation of tracers under a scan to find the source of the bleeding. So when you boil this down, the doctor is collecting, analyzing, and visualizing data to observe what's going on inside your body. This way, the doctor is alerted when something's off, so she can talk to you to get more context. Then she can further explore what's happening and where this is happening. From there, the doctor could get the right teams to solve a problem. And once the problem is addressed, she can come up with a plan to prevent this from happening in the future. We can apply the same analogy to observability in software systems. When I say software systems, I'm referring to an application or an infrastructure that runs the application. Our goal is to observe what's going on within our system so we're aware when something's off. We can get context about what's happening and where this is happening so we can get the right teams to fix the problem. Then we can come up with a plan to prevent this from happening in the future. Let's go back to our previous example and compare it to observability in software systems. Just as our bodies consist of multiple systems that are interdependent on one another, our modern software systems can consist of complex, multi-layered, and distributed systems with many interdependencies. Because of that, if something were to go wrong, it would make finding the issue that much harder. The goal of observability is to understand the performance, behavior, and health of your system by analyzing data from various data sources. And some of the most common data we collect to observe software systems are metrics, logs, and traces. Metrics are numerical data that provide clues about the health and performance of our software systems. In our previous example, we talked about collecting vital signs over time. When different systems of your body are functioning the way it's supposed to, these vital signs will stay within a normal range. If any of these vital signs drop below a certain threshold, the alarm will sound to let you know that something is happening. This is directly applicable to observability metrics. We can collect numerical data over time that provides clues about the performance of our systems. depending on what we want to observe, the type of data we collect will differ. Some examples of most common metrics collected are response time, request served, CPU capacity, error rate, etc. And just like the vital signs monitor, you can set up your observability solution to send you alerts if metrics hit a certain threshold. So you're alerted if something's going on, so you can look into it. And if we know something's off, the next step is to figure out what is happening. Just as a doctor would talk to a patient to get more context, we can refer to logs to get more context to what's going on within our system. Logs are text records of events that have occurred within our system, and these provide clues about when the problem occurred and which events are correlated with it. Okay, so let's do a quick recap. Metrics alerts us that something's happening, and logs tells us what's happening. It'd be really helpful to know where the problem is so we can fix the problem. And this is where traces come into play. In our previous example, we used tracers to track how the blood moves throughout your body and to locate the source of the bleeding. In observability, we can use traces to track application requests as they travel throughout our systems. We observe how the request interacts with various functions, methods, and services within our software system. And if there's a bottleneck, we'll be able to trace where exactly that is happening so we could address the issue. As you can see, metrics, logs, and traces provide unique information about our software systems. And they also complement one another to give you a more comprehensive view of the health and performance of our systems as well. Later in the series, we'll be delving deeper into observability and going over metrics, logs, and traces more in detail. The point of this episode is to get a high-level understanding of observability so you have the basics to understand more complex concepts down the road. Now, as you learn more, you'll frequently hear observability mentioned in the context of DevOps. In the next episode, we'll be talking about DevOps, and this will help us build a foundation to understand the role that observability plays in DevOps in future episodes. Last but not least, this episode is a part of the Grafana for Beginners series. To access more episodes, check out the playlist on our Grafana YouTube channel. Later in the series, we'll delve into how Grafana is used to observe our systems. To access more Grafana-related resources and to become a part of our community, check out our Grafana community webpage. You'll also be able to access the forum through this website to ask any questions about Grafana. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.